Hey folks, it's Frithgar here. How you doing? Today we have, well, I see I've got loads of different things that I want to do. I would like to seed that field out there, and I think I'm going to try and get some of that done today. I have brought back this one from field 5. We will quickly hose this one off and we can put that one away. I'm going to use the John Deere to operate the seeder, and then I'm going to use this one here. We're going to take some of the silage up to the beef and the pigs, and then we're going to take silage over to the biogas plant, because if you remember in our last episode, we got a great demand come up for silage at the biogas plant. Where is it? Biotech? No, it was here somewhere. Pub biomass, not biomass heating. It must be in the biotech. Yes. Pub biotech, and scroll down to, there we go. Right, we are getting £3,000 a ton. We got another 17 hours, so we definitely want to be taking some silage up there. Before we do that, today's question. This is the last of the daily questions being answered. I asked you which sugar beet harvesting, here we go, the beet harvesting, which beet harvesting gear you wanted me to use when I come to harvest that huge great big field of sugar beet. I will just hire it, I won't buy it. And I asked you which ones you wanted me to use, and it was completely unanimous. You would like me to hire some Holmer equipment, the new stuff, and use that to harvest the sugar beet. So when I do, I will use the Holmer stuff. Now, our weekly question, the one that I'm asking all this week, is which baler do you want me to buy? Do you want me to buy this Case LB434-R square baler? Or do you want me to get this Krone Ultima CF155XC round baler? So which one do you want? Do you want me to get the Krone round baler or the Case square baler? It's your vote. It's your game. Now, I think I will leave that a second. I want to get this silage, and then we can hopefully sell enough that we can buy a seeder. And I'm even thinking, before I do that though, let's just quickly rinse off this tractor here. And I've also got a load of eggs that I need to gather. If you see the eggs there, I've got the eggs in the backpack for 27, but I've got 15, and that is the maximum number that you can get hanging around that you've got to pick up. So we need to just go and collect the eggs out of that old bus back there. And we haven't done that for several episodes. I've been doing it off screen, so I thought you wouldn't mind just seeing that quickly. I'm standing on the actual sprayer here for a minute. And someone pointed out to me, who was it? I'm afraid I cannot remember his name. I know that he has a channel, and he has told me that he will be doing machinery restoration videos soon, which I think is actually pretty cool. But he did say in one of the videos that by buying the Lamborghini, we actually bought the Deutz here. We've bought their big brother, because they're made by the same company. They're owned by the same parent company, which is actually a pretty cool little bit of trivia, I thought. That was pretty good. Tango 6, he also pointed out that when we do the seeding in the field, we don't actually get the crop destruction kick in until we have plants showing. So we can fertilize just after doing the seeding if we want to. Right, that's nice and clean there. And McStallion pointed out, and I didn't actually write down the full number, but it was around about £566 per beef animal that we got. You know, when we were selling the beef animals last time, we were getting roughly £566. There was some pennies as well, I believe, but I can't actually remember the precise number. So if I just back this one in here, he can go right there, drop that one down there, and switch off. Okay, so we'll leave the Deutz there for now. We'll run over and we'll collect the eggs, and then I'm going to, yeah, I think I'll put the Lamborghini onto the trailer, because it's a faster tractor and it is slightly more powerful, so we will get through the whole thing a lot quicker. So let's just grab these eggs really quickly. I really do love this touch here of having them in an old bus. I have mentioned it before, I do think it is very cool, and I will say it again. I think it's very cool. I love that. Right, anyway, I'm not going to hang around too much, because we're very, very busy. Lots of things to do. Very important. I left the John Deere over here, around the corner. So I'll go and get that one. I will look up, in a little while, if I can, who it was that... Oop, I just want to open this gate, because I'm going to spin round in the field, and then I can unhitch the trailer just here, and then we'll get the Lamborghini onto it. and I think that would just be a quicker way of doing it. So let's go into cab a second, start this tractor up. There we go. Right, we'll go into the cattle field and spin round, and then we will come back out and swap the tractors over, and we can load this trailer up. I'm thinking actually we might take our first load straight up to the biogas plant, and then the next load after that we can take to the, let me just see if I've out the field properly, yep, there we go. The load after that we could take up to the beef and the sheep, the beef and the pigs. I keep wanting to say beef and sheep. The main reason I want to say beef and sheep all the time is because many years ago I worked on quite a large estate. I have mentioned that before, I think. And the estate that we had normal arable crops that we sprayed and fertilised and all the rest of it. But we also had beef and sheep, and those were organic. So I'm used to saying beef and sheep, because that is what we had. We had, what was it? It was about 200 organic beef cattle and 400 organic sheep. And I'm so used to saying beef and sheep that it's still going, even now, more than... That's nearly 15 years ago, crumbs. That was a long time ago. So yeah, I'm used to saying beef and sheep all the time. Oops, getting a bit hasty here. Right, I'm gonna take this one over, and we wanna fill this trailer up, and then we'll rush it up to the biogas plant and see how much money we can get up there. And I think we're gonna get quite a bit. Now, I actually filled up a trailer of this. Was it my? It was the episode before last, so I don't think you actually need to see me filling this. So I'm going to jump ahead now, and I will do this little bit off screen because you've already seen it, and I don't want to bore you with too much of it because there's other things that I want to do today. And then once I've filled and taken this up, I will we can have a look and see how much that we're going to get for it all. Just pulling into the yard here, and hopefully that conveyor hasn't moved at all, because sometimes they have a habit of just sort of shuffling themselves around a little. I did just double check who it was that I was talking about, you know, the name I couldn't remember, and it was Dreadnought. So thank you very much, Dreadnought. If I just back up in here and turn round, right, I will sell this, and I'm hoping that I can buy the seeder, you know, the direct drill. We want to get that one as soon as we can, because we need to do some planting. That is getting fairly high on our list of things to do. And if I can buy the seeder, I'll probably leave the any more silage until next episode. I'd like to buy the seeder, but I'm also thinking that just because I can buy the seeder now, I won't start tonight. Hang on. Oh, there we go. Right. Let's start tipping, and let's see how much... Ooh, look at the money pouring in this time. Oh, this is going to be great. We're getting nearly double. Well, I think we are getting double, actually. It is fully double what we were getting last time. So, another 10,000, I think, and we got enough to buy that seeder. Oh, this is brilliant. I'm thinking that we should... Well, we can do another load in the night, or I can do another load off-screen, maybe. We will save a bit of silage for the beef and the pigs, and we will take that up to them. Right, that's now dropping down. We've got £85,000. 86. That is a huge amount of money. 79,000 we got for that, and we didn't even empty it. Right, let's first, we'll buy the sewing machine, because that's the one that was 52,000 for this one. It's a 6-meter sewing machine. I'm not going to start using this one tonight. I will use that in the next episode. We'll go up and we'll make a date of it with field 5. I do want to check in the garage, do we have a fertilizer spreader? I don't know if we do. We got several other things. We got beef, cows, we got that mower, the Rossel mash, Marshall trailer, pig speed. Right, we don't have a fertilizer spreader, so we do need to get a fertilizer spreader. And we've got the Amazon here, which is a 26 meter width. That's a pretty good one. This one here only has a 12 meter width and a 700, 3000, and this one is 8000. Although this one, this is a fantastic machine, but I don't think we really need it. I think this is going to be the good one. This is a pretty, you know, it's a solid workhorse that we could use. Fertilizer spreaders, or we've got this little tiny one. which we won't be using here. Okay, so let's just buy that fertilizer spreader a second. There we go. Buy that one. And that still leaves me with £20,000. Oh, there is one other thing that I want to get. Then this is a mod that is really, really cool. I really like this one. And you won't be able to see very much of it from here. It's this one here. This one is a portable seed pallet. Now, if you watch my... let's just buy it. If you watch my series that I do for... My time-lapse series, I should say. If you watch my time-lapse series, you will see that I have used this one before. And it is pretty awesome. I really like it. I've never had any problems with it. So I'd like to sort of introduce that one to the camera. 2,700. I want to use all of this up before I go off to get another load. And I'll probably sell the next load off screen, because what I'm thinking now is... Actually, we'll leave this here. Let's just switch off. We can always come back and sort that out later. We'll walk back to the yard, and we're going to get the John Deere, and we're going to start doing some seeding. I think we've got enough time before dark to seed the little field right in front of us with the grass. We're going to cut across the countryside, straight up through here. I'll just shut the door there, and there we go. Right, let's start this one up. I'm going to get this hitched onto the small seeder, and after we've done this little field... I don't know if we need to even keep that cedar. We do have it here, but I don't think we're going to need to keep it after this, because the rest of the fields aren't that small. And it doesn't seem to be a need for keeping two seed machines. So I will just... Let's just back in and collect that one. There we go. Right, at the moment it's on wheat, and I want this to be on grass. So put that onto grass. I need to fill it up. We've got seed pallets right there. Come down here and then back up, and I can't see anything here, so I don't know if I'm going to be hitting anything, so I will just come out of cab so that I can see. There we go, back around the corner, and there, is that close enough? Yes. Right, so we fill that one up. We got grass seed going in there. It doesn't actually take very much. It only holds 600 litres, which isn't a huge amount when it comes to seeds. I'm hoping that's enough just to seed this field here. But fortunately, it doesn't cost a huge amount either. We've still got £17,000. And I'm not sure what we're going to buy next, because by the time I sell another load of silage, I think actually we will get some more stock. That would be pretty good. And then I've also got... What else have I got? I got... I want to make some more silage, don't I? I want to silage... Right, this field's going to be really rough because it's only been ploughed and hasn't been cultivated as well. So, I didn't actually mean to do that. I want to do that, and then I can get out to shut the gate because that is going to be in the way. So, we've got the straw plant down there. That is going to be slightly in our way. I need to get a little bit closer. There we go. Right, that's that one closing. I will start over in this corner. No, it would help if I shut the door. There we go. Right. I'm going to do this out of cab to start with so that we can see what's going on. And if you're familiar with sowing grass, you'll know that it basically just rubs out the field is all it does. Look at that. I really like the way that this mod is sinks you into the ground like this. It is particularly effective when you do ploughing, and I would like to do some ploughing at some point in the future, so that is on my to-do list. Now, the next thing we need to do is, if I lower that one down, like so, I want V to turn it on. Oh no, that's to lower it, sorry. I want the ridge marker. The ridge marker is actually quite important when you're doing it yourself. I used to use the ridge marker a lot in 2013, but I've got to be honest, I haven't used it a lot in this one. So turn on the sower. That should be everything. We should just be able to go now. And the ridge marker isn't doing a huge amount. It is doing what it's supposed to do, but it's not doing a fantastic job. It's leaving too wide a stripe, I think. Partly because, of the ploughed field. Partly, I think, because it's such a small cedar, it's sort of affecting it like that a little bit. Let's just pick that one up. I can leave the ridge marker down. I'm going to come into cab a little bit for this. And if I drive around there, now the problem is you can't see behind you very well because of this guy with his headless torso. And lower down there, right, and now we come driving up the side here, and it does sort of, it's really rough here. This is brilliant. Okay, let's just pop out so that we can just see that it is covering all the ground, because that's the only thing that we can't see, is if it's actually filling it all in. And I'm going to do a couple of rounds. I think we'll do a couple of rounds like we normally do, and then we'll leave it to the hired worker to continue. And then I don't know if I've got enough time. If I've got enough time, I will get some more silage. That's what I would like to do. I'd like to take a little bit more silage and take that up to the beef and the pigs. And we will... I got it right that time. I actually said beef and pigs properly. There we go. Let's pick that one up. It's getting around this piece. I don't think I have got enough time to do this today, actually. I think the silage for the beef and the pigs will be in our next episode. So we will do that. That is going to be next week, because tomorrow I am starting my brand new series, because obviously I'm 7 days a week farming simulator, but I am not doing 7 days a week on Melbury Estate. I am starting a different map tomorrow. It is going to be a themed map, but I'm not telling you anything else about it until I actually launch the first episode. I think, well, at least I hope everybody's going to like it. I've put a lot of thought into this. It is something that I've wanted to try for quite a long time. So hopefully you all enjoy it. Now, this is going to be the difficult bit. I've got to do a lot of sort of shunting around. We will pick up the ridge marker, because that's not really going to be very important. And you can see the ridge marker is leaving too big a stripe there. It's not working very well. I'm going to back up a little bit. There we go. And first of all, I'm going to do a line straight along here and hope that I can get it as tight to that plant, the straw power plant, as I can. There we go. Actually, that's working all right. It is allowing me to overlap it ever so slightly, which does help. Now, if I come around this way, excuse me, and lower that down, there we go. Right, it's coming up right along the edge of it. I'm going to have to put a little bit of a stripe along the back. And I've also got some more stuff. We're going to be using this straw power plant quite a bit soon, because we've got two fields that we've got to bale up. So we need to get those done soon. And I'm hoping, actually, because of the amount of money that we're getting from the silage, I'm hoping that we will actually be able to afford to buy the baler very soon. The one that I've been asking you about this week. So we might be able to, next week, buy the baler and use that to bale up the straw. It does mean we'll be able to sell this seeding machine, this seeder, and we will also be able to sell the small New Holland round baler that we've got. That will add a little bit of money to our funds. We got £70,000 from that trailer full, and we didn't even sell it all. I think we're getting close to £80,000 for one trailer full of silage, and we've got, I think we can get away with selling two more trailer fulls of silage and still be able to put some up for the beef and the pigs. And then after that, we will be able to, hopefully, right, I don't want to drive into that, oops, do not drive into the old bulldozer, we will come off worse. Okay, let's pick that up, and now all I got to do is back up. I think I'll do this with one more stripe. And then that is everything around the straw power plant, all carefully seeded out. There we go. Just a little tiny bit left there. Tiny bit. Yeah, we'll sell those. We will get the straw done, and then I would like to make silage, and I'm hoping that I can get a new header for the Rossel mash, and either it'll be a pickup header, we will mow all of the grass and row it up and then use a pickup header, or we will use the whole crop header. I think the whole crop header would probably be better, because I think that one will actually allow us to use the hired help. And I did say before, I don't want to use the sort of the big script mods like course play and stuff like that. And the main reason that I don't My timer is actually going to say that I have run out of time. I've been here talking for far too long, and we've already run out of time, and all we've done is sell one load of silage and do a little bit of seeding. So I will sell two more loads of silage and have the rest of the silage loaded up for the beef and the pigs. And anything that we're going to buy, I will buy that at the beginning of the next episode. And I will also allow this one to finish out. I will probably do another round around the field. Just pick that up. And let's pop into cab now and see what the ridge marker has done. See how effective it's been. It's all right, but you've got such a wide mark down that it's not actually that great. The old ridge marker, that used to be give you a narrower mark in 2013. Like I said, I never actually used it in this game. Oh well. We'll just carry on like this. I've only got to do a couple more rounds, and then I can let the hired hand do the rest of it. So, yes, I will sell some more silage and have the money there ready for us. I would like to hopefully be able to buy the baler next week so that we can bale up the straw and buy the gear for the Rossel Mash, the forager that we've got, so that we can do some grass silage and take that over to the clamps at the biogas plant. Maybe make some more silage at the clamp here if we empty this one out completely. And yeah, after that I'm not really sure. I'd like to make lots of silage, but obviously time also, we don't want to be spending all of our time doing that. But anyway, the question for this week was, which of the two balers do you want me to get? Is it the Case square baler or the Krone round baler? You've seen them enough times now that you know what they look like. Head down below and let me know what you think. Look out tomorrow for my brand new series. It's running along a very tight theme. I will not deviate from that theme unless I absolutely have to and the game mechanics force me to, although I don't think we will need to. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to doing this one. I've got the map all picked out. All I got to do is just run a few tests to make sure that it all works perfectly. So if you enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.